Hey, it's Kevin from Synthesia, and today I'm going to show you 7 ways to use ChatGPT in your workflow for creating videos faster. It's not going to replace you doing the actual work, but I'll show you how to use ChatGPT responsibly as your thinking buddy. Tip number one, start by setting the role and goal for ChatGPT. Whenever you start a project with ChatGPT, you want to tell ChatGPT who it is and the task that it's supposed to do. So a prompt I might put in here is, act as a YouTuber with 300,000 subscribers who creates videos for older professionals with using Excel and Google Sheets. I want you to give me 3 ideas for a YouTube video that tackles the most common problems for data analysts. By adding more detail, particularly into the task and format, you're gonna increase your chances that ChatGPT is gonna output something that you can actually use that's not too generic. Tip number 2 is using ChatGPT to research and summarize your content. Your AI thinking buddy can help you summarize articles and provide best-in-class explanations. I can do this for blog posts, research papers, or even survey results. So let me show you how. So our prompt here is, you wanna digest this content, and your answer should be in this format. So for blog posts, you can copy and paste in the entire URL and ask for a format in 5 bullet points. So for example, I have this article from Wistia on the power of including human faces in video. I'm just gonna put digest, copy and paste this URL into ChatGPT, and then ask for a format back in 5 bullet points. For research papers, the topics are going to be a little bit more complex, so I'm going to copy and paste the abstract from this research paper into ChatGPT, and I'm going to ask for it to output and format that output in 2 to 3 sentences at the level of a third grader's explanation. Remember that you should always tweak those responses if something doesn't make sense. Tip number 3 is about designing personas and characters. When I'm creating a video that uses a digital human, I give them characteristics and personas and backstories to make them more interesting. First, I have ChatGPT digest several articles or resources to give it some background information before creating my characters. Next, I use this prompt. Generate this character with this job in this context, include characteristics, for example, physical appearance, personality elements, flaws, relationships, and the ultimate journey of their character, and add a bonus anecdote of 3 sentences or less. I might write, based on these articles and your knowledge of the L&D landscape, generate 3 L&D characters that might struggle with this new jump to using AI-enabled tools for varying reasons. This not only creates personas, but it also gives you characteristics to map onto your synthetic human to help you tell your story or communicate your idea better to your audience. The anecdote at the end is what really brings the character to life for you when you're writing the script. Tip number 4 is about creating content outlines. Another great use for ChatGPT is to have it help you come up with a first draft of a course outline or a video outline. It can be difficult to figure out what order to explain new information to your viewers, but it's just not a problem for ChatGPT. A content outline, in our case, matches the O from our FOCA framework. If you want to learn more about our FOCA framework for creating videos, then check out this video right here. A video outline is going to contain 3 parts. It's going to include the hook, a key topic, and 3 supporting examples. So I'm going to write a content outline with the following pieces in my prompt. I'll say, write a content outline with the following pieces. A catchy hook in this format and tone for a video about this topic. Choose 1 key topic, task, or skill to explain. Provide 3 supporting examples or data with sources to support understanding of that task. That includes 1 explanation or summary, 1 everyday metaphor, and 1 real-world example or case study. So an example of this might be, write a catchy hook with a spicy question for a video about securing your computer against phishing attacks. Choose 1 key topic, task, or skill to explain, and then the rest of the prompt. Remember, tweak the output until it gives you something that matches what you're looking for. Like if the example is too old in the content outline that it generates, ask it to generate a new example. Tip number 5 is about creating examples and scenarios to help explain your concept. Creating examples and scenarios is a good way to show your audience what you're talking about and to help reinforce what you're teaching. You're going to use a storytelling prompt that has all the different elements that you need to tell a story and follows the story arc. So our prompt for this is write a scenario in which this character struggles to solve this problem but can't do it because of this obstacle. They eventually overcome this problem with a solution, which ultimately leads to this outcome. So an example for this prompt might be, write a scenario in which Kevin, a learning strategist, struggles to use ChatGPT to explain ChatGPT prompts, but can't seem to get answers that are specific enough to teach his audience. He eventually overcomes the problem by entering more and more prompts, which eventually leads to this outcome. Tip number 6 is about using ChatGPT to write better video titles and hooks. If you're like most content creators, then you know how important it is to come up with a catchy title and a hook to draw in your audience and have them watch your video. My prompt for this is write 5 versions of a tone hook for this video about this topic for this audience that covers how to do this skill. Your answer should be 6 words or less. An example of this might be, write 5 versions of a catchy hook for a video about giving and receiving feedback for new hires at a SaaS startup that covers the way to format your feedback to a colleague. Your answer should be 1 YouTube title and the hook for that title. As always, don't forget to correct your ChatGPT thinking buddy with a few more prompts to tweak it to get what you want. Tip number 7 is about writing better prompts. You can ask ChatGPT for prompt formulas. Our prompt here is, give me an example of a prompt for a type of content with formatting details, then give me the prompt formula that should be formatted with the text to input and with a generic key element for other prompts framed in brackets. Three things to remember. Number 1, don't ask for specific data points or insights from ChatGPT. They could be generic or completely made up. Number 2, always edit and fine-tune the responses you get from ChatGPT. If you don't understand something that was in the output, you can always type in, explain it like I'm 5. Tip number 3 is refer back to the information in your ChatGPT window. All of the information that you output and input in ChatGPT is stored, so you can refer back to certain details or prompts that you generated so that you can build off of that and create more detailed outputs in your new questions for ChatGPT. That's all we have for you today. Happy experimenting with ChatGPT. I'm looking forward to the videos that you're going to create. Don't forget to like and subscribe to Synthesia Academy for more tips and tricks on how to create AI videos. Thanks for stopping by.